Before you can create a pivot table in Excel, you need to understand the format that Excel likes its data to come in. So here we have a simple database relating to salespeople, some products sold. A couple of things you need to realize. The first thing is that pivot tables require that every single column has a label in it. So you'll see, for example, that here we don't have a label. And if you try to set up a pivot table, it'll explain that there's a problem with this. You either need to delete these columns, or else what I like to do is just give it a label. And in this case, I'm going to just call it blank. And if you had another column, you'd call it blank 1, blank 2, etc. Because at some stage, you may actually need these extra columns. The second thing to understand is that the column labels have to be unique. Excel is going to use these to decide what type of reports it will create. So having two columns called product, like this one here and this one here, will cause a problem and the pivot table won't be created. So we need to make sure that they're all unique. So for example, I'm going to go here and just change the name to be sales. Another thing about the column headings is that the pivot table cannot have a merged cell. So you can see here I've got the date description, but it is merged and applies to those two columns. You cannot have that, so you need to unmerge the cells. So in this case, I'm going to go here, get rid of the merged cells. And you'll see now we've got this other problem where we've got a column without a header, which we need to fix. And in this case, I'm actually going to just take these down, because these two provide the correct label. Also, it is important that your labels are descriptive. So you'll see here, just having date 1 or date 2 would be problematic. Here we can see we've got an order date and a delivery date. With the nature of pivot tables and what they do, which is take a whole chunk of information and do various sortings on them, it is unnecessary to have these subtotals built into a report. The pivot table will do all of this on its own, so the database must come without the subtotals. So in this case, I'm just going to go and delete all of these. The pivot table also has some special functionality built in to handle dates. But before it can use this functionality, it needs to recognize the data as a date. So if you look here, you'll see that the order date is represented as a number. So there's 2009-09-25, but Excel is not recognizing that as a date. So you need to convert this somehow to be in a date format that Excel recognizes. Another requirement of pivot tables is that each line must contain all the information relating to that line. So for example here, as a human, I can assume that these two headers apply all the way to here. However, Excel does not assume it, and it actually needs to be able to include there London and Ben as the city and salesperson, so that when it does its sorting and categorization and summarization, it knows what information it applies to it. So ideally, we should not have blanks in any of the columns. They should have information that describes the entire row of information. So for a pivot table to work, your data cannot really look like that. What it should do is look something like this. You'll notice every column has got a header. The headers are all descriptive. They're all unique. There are no blanks. All these numbers have been filled in. The dates now are represented as a date and are recognized as a date. There are no merged cells. And all subtotals have been removed. Once you're in this format, you can actually get on to building a pivot table.